Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. All right, so this video is who has been fantasizing about you, details about the fantasy, what type of fantasy, what is the fantasy, and what action or what will they do about that fantasy? Like, will they make that fantasy a reality? Let's find out. All right, for those of you that are brand spanking new to my channel, this is your first time viewing one of my videos, please hit the subscribe button and that bell notification. I drop videos weekly. Also, for those of you who have been riding along this crazy ride with me since the beginning, I thank you. For those of you who just hopped on midway, thank you at whatever point you joined. Thank you. Thank you for your energy. As always, information about personal readings are in the description box of this video. Check out the heading, book a personal reading. There's a link to my Etsy there where you can book. All right, so let's jump straight into our reading. I have three piles for you all today. This is going to be pile number one. This is going to be pile number two. And this is going to be pile number three. Again, pile one, pile two, and pile three. All right, as always, please take the time out to pause the video. See which of these piles resonates with you the most. Again, these are general messages. So if you want something that pertains specifically to you, go to the link in the description box to my Etsy, the book of reading. These general messages is filling from the energies of everyone who looks at the video as well as subscribe to this channel. So if you get a message that does not pertain to you, that is perfectly fine. There is a video that will be coming soon for you. I'm sure of it. Alrighty, so let's get into this really juicy video. Who has been fantasizing about you? What is the fantasy? You know what keep on popping in my head, you all? What's that song by Ludacris? Tell me what's your fantasy with featuring Shauna. Is it what's your fantasy? Was it tell me what's your fantasy? I don't know. Either way, I'm gonna link that here because yeah, I feel like it's some hot buttery stuff that may have become that may come up from this. We'll see. All right, so pile number one, let's jump into your reading. Who's been fantasizing about you? What's the details of their fantasy? And are they ultimately going to take action on that fantasy? Ooh, and how long have they been fantasizing? Not how long. What was it? Time of day that they've fantasized about you most. Yeah, that's, I also want to know that because, yeah, that interests me. You know, are they distracted? All right, jumping in. We have the Seven of Cups in the upright. We have the Two of Swords in the upright. Thank you, universe, for the messages coming through. We have the Five of Wands in the reverse. So this is someone that's trying to fight off thinking about you. What I'm picking up is you come up in their thoughts unexpectedly throughout the day. We have the Five of Cups in the upright. This is someone, okay. I'm picking up X vibes. This is someone that may have let you go. Either this is someone you were in a relationship with or someone that you were involved with casually, but they let you go. Someone that you may have had a lot of arguments with, but those arguments have, you know, ceased because you all aren't really in contact right now. The someone I'm getting who made a decision to this Two of Swords in relation to communication. I'm getting made a decision to stop texting you or, you know, to kind of give you the boot. And not to say that in like a horrible way, but this is someone with the Seven of Cups who is out here trying to find other options, or this is you in one of these options, you know, or them thinking about the possibilities of you. This is definitely someone who thinks about you sexually a lot, but more so in a reminiscent sense. And though they're thinking about you sexually, they're thinking about the possibilities of what will occur if they decide to come back and be serious with you. We have the Six of Cups. So this is someone I'm getting either from the past, like I said, a past relationship, a past situationship, someone that was a friend even, or someone that you're friends with or friend vibes. But this is someone that thinks about you at unexpected times of the day. You just pop into their thoughts. There's a friendship there. Or was a friendship there, or there's an hiatus in a friendship or some sort. This is someone that you were very close to, or someone from definitely from your past. We have the Knight of Wands. Yeah, this is someone, in terms of what I'm getting through in signs, I am picking up fire energy. I'm picking up fire energy. Faintly, I'm picking up some earth energy. Maybe this is someone with a lot of fire in a chart, or a fire sun or moon with a lot of earth in the chart, or, you know, or the vice versa, you know, flip that around. Or that's you. However, yeah, I am picking up. Yeah, this is someone that you all got it on a lot. Like, this is someone that you think about, that you think about sexually a lot too. You know, someone that you're with in that way, or were with, you know, was with it in that way. The High Priestess. So yeah, this is someone where it's like, okay, so what I'm getting with this is, so remember I told you, like, they think about you at just at random times throughout the day. You just pop up into their mind and it just, like, takes them aback. Like, whoa, I was not expecting that. Yeah, this is someone who does not want to admit how much, you know, how, just how crazy they are about you. Because I'm picking up someone that's not ready for a relationship, but they want a relationship with you. That's where this High Priestess in reverse. It's like they want it and they're trying to fight that wanting off. Nine of Pentacles. Yeah. So I told you I'm picking up a little bit of earth energy. I'm picking up a Taurus, more so, you know, in terms of earth. But yeah, this is someone, yeah, that definitely thinks about you throughout the day. This is someone that thinks about you at work, even, you know, see the Pentacles. This is someone who thinks about you when they're working. This is someone who even thinks about you when they're on other dates. Like, this person thinks about you, and it's like they're trying to run from these feelings, you know, they're trying to hide from these feelings. Because what I'm picking up is that this may be someone who just can't give you what you want at the moment, or they don't feel that they can give you what you want, in regards to what you want. So, yeah, but in terms of, yeah, what's their fantasy? They definitely... This is someone who fantasizes about you sexually, because you've all had this connection. This is what I'm picking up on. This is someone who fantasizes, you know, like someone maybe you have bickered with, someone who's very disappointed about the fact that they have let you go out of their life. Someone from your past, or someone that you're very familiar with, someone that you were once friends with even, you know, or this was a friendship that turned into a relationship type of thing. But yeah, this is someone, yeah, who in terms of, yeah, sign, I'm getting faint earth energy. Maybe I'm having a Taurus that comes through in terms of earth, and of course this can apply to any sign, in terms of, you know, who it is that, I'm like losing my train of thought as I say this, but yeah, because it was like so many components to this question. I'm getting a lot of fire energy. This is either a lot of fire in the chart, or, you know, sun or moon, fire sign, heavy for this person. This is someone that, it's like the relationship could not get right. It wasn't solid. But they've very much been thinking about you. I am picking up a masculine energy. So this may be male, or if this is female, this is someone with a lot of masculine energy. But yeah, this is someone, yeah, they think about you a lot. Just at random times of the day, you just pop up into their mind. And in terms of action, we have the Empress in the reverse. So this is someone who wants a relationship with you, someone who sees, you know, who wants you. You are their ideal, but at this time they're choosing not to act on their fantasies, because their fantasies are mixed. Their fantasies for you are very sexual in nature, but also they also fantasize, you know, a life, a relationship with you. But right now, they're not going to take action on that with that Empress in the reverse. This person just, I'm getting a sense of energy. This person really doesn't know exactly what it is that they want or why. That's what that is. All right. So thank you for those of you who chose pile number one. Let me know in my comment section how that resonated, if that resonated. And if you'd like to know more about something that pertains strictly to you, book a reading with me, info in the description area. So let's find out pile number two. Who's been fantasizing about you? What's the detail of those fantasies? Like, what is this fantasy? You know, what is it? what time of the day, like, when do they fantasize about you most? And let's find out, what was it? Yeah. Action. Will they take action towards you? Will they act on that fantasy? So let's find out. We got the Emperor in reverse. So yeah. Okay. So I'm getting somebody who can't, you know, they don't have control over how they feel about you. Temperance. This is someone who's very so, you know, this is interesting. So we got the Emperor in reverse. So generally this is someone who's like, you know, probably, you know, maybe a little bit older than you even, you know, this is someone who usually has a good handle on their feelings, or they're very disciplined, but yet at the same time, you know, with this in reverse, you know, it's like they can't control what they want. It's like the heart wants what the heart wants. I am getting the sense that maybe this person is committed to someone else, but this person definitely is patient, and how they approach you, because it's like this person doesn't want to approach you in the wrong way. But I am getting that this person may be with someone else, or maybe a little bit older than you, but this is someone, yeah, it's like, but they can't control how they feel about you. But I'm getting, like, even with this Temperance card, it's like they watch you from afar, even, you know, like they have some type of contact with you, or maybe they're always complimenting you, but it's like in a way where they're treading a line, you know. It's like, okay, I don't want to walk over that line because but yeah, they're watching you. Three of Cups. Yep, told you, Three of Cups. So this is someone I'm picking up that's in a relationship with you, or maybe they want to have a threesome with you. I am picking up, yeah, that they've had thoughts like that about you. But this is someone, yeah, that's with someone else. I am picking up strong marriage vibes. So maybe this person is married, or maybe this person is very committed. Very, very committed. But it's like, you know, they're not making moves towards you because, you know, because of this other relationship. But they can't stop thinking about you. They can't stop thinking about you. For some of you, this is a coworker. They cannot stop thinking about you. Like, for real. This person I'm picking up, they think about you late at night a lot. Two of Swords. Yeah, this is someone. I think the Two of Swords over there pop up. Okay. So, yeah, Two of Swords. This is someone who's conflicted, because it's like they know. I mean, I don't want to say they know they shouldn't be thinking about you. They're a human being. But the way they think about you, and with the intensity that they think about you, this is someone who thinks about, you know, like, going out with you. It's like, even with the Three of Cups, this person wants to take you out. Like, this is someone who is thinking about, you know, okay, how can I justify going out on a date with them, but not calling it a date, so it won't necessarily be a date, so I could justify it with the person that I'm with, but at the same time, I don't run this person away, because I also am getting that you are attracted to this person too. That's what's coming through. You're attracted to this person too. It's a bit of, you know, taboo, you know, hidden feelings, you know. I'm feeling like, you know, energetic flirtation, you know, there's not anything covert, you know, there's not anything overt that's going on, with you all. It's more covert, you know. It's like, you know, you can feel those vibes strong, and it's like, you know, you all, you know, it's like you say one thing, but it's meaning something completely different. Like, your energy is completely enmeshed with this person, and they're trying to see how they can go out with you. But yeah, we got the Sun. So this is someone who feel a lot of guilt in relation to this, because, yeah, once again, it's like they feel the way that they think about you, they're very sexually attracted to you, but they're very attracted to you in general. It's like, yeah, they want to do, you know, like, you know, they want to have that.
Though, with the Sun being in reverse, it's like, yeah, they just have some, they have some doubts. It's something that's stopping them from making this move towards you. But what I'm picking up with the Sun card, yeah, though they think about, it's like they're trying to figure out how to turn this right side up, how to make success out of this with the Sun, how to ask you out. I am getting that this person is going to take some sort of action towards you. I'm not saying, I don't know if that's a good or bad thing, you know, knowing that this person is, you know, more than likely tied into a very, you know, committed relationship with someone else. But I am picking up that you had these feelings for this person too. They fantasize about you just in an all around, and I'm getting like, yeah, they fantasize about you at night. Yeah. For some of you, they even fantasize about you at work, or this is someone that you work with. But yeah. So yeah, we have the 9 of Wands. So yeah, this is something that definitely brings them a bit of anxiety, because it's like, yeah, these thoughts, they know they're not supposed to, you know. Yeah, that's all I can say. It's anxiety. Because these thoughts that they have about you, yeah, this is someone who knows that they are definitely in a relationship with a commitment with someone else. And yeah, so this person, or maybe this person will work with you, you know, or find a way to work with you. This is someone who's going to try to find a way to act on their fantasies, but in the right way, if you can see that quotation mark right there, if that makes sense. Meaning someone who, you know, their proposed work with you, you know, or to work with you in some sort of capacity, you know, just so they can be next to you. This is someone who wants to act on their curiosity. Yeah, the Queen of Swords. This is not being communicated to you, you know, how they feel about you. And Ace of Cups, yeah, this is someone that's going to go forth. They're going to act on their fantasy. Yeah, this is someone, they not only fantasize about you, yet physically, they're attracted to you just overall, but they fantasize about taking you out. That's like the big, you know, like that's the most of how their fantasies go. It's like they're fantasizing about going out with you, spending time with you. This is someone who's going to figure out a way to make this thing happen. Even if it's like, you know, assigning you, you know, if this is someone you work with, picking you to work on a project with, or, you know, just finding a way to be alone with you, doing some work with you, you know, like almost like, yeah, this person is being patient, almost like easing their way into this relationship with you. This is someone who will, if they are in a situation with someone else, will explore the possibilities. This may turn into an affair. I'm picking that up, but this is someone who is going to figure out a way to take action towards you about the situation. But, you know, just cautionary, you know, I am picking up that this is someone who's in a very committed relationship, either married or either very stable, very committed with this person, live with this person, you know, with this person. So if you are, you know, if you do proceed past go with this person, just know what's over there. There is a third party situation happening, but I am picking up that the majority of you, if someone came to mind when you heard these details, you know, it's like you knew of that. And I am picking up a strong attraction for you towards this person too. I'm picking up heavy on air signs of the sign of this person. It could be anybody, of course, but I'm picking very much air sign. Once again, I'm picking up, I'm picking up a lot of air. This could be someone with a lot of air in their chart. This could be anyone actually, you know, because definitely these signs aren't specific, but what I'm picking up heavy is air. All right. So thank you for those of you who chose pile number 2. Let me know in the comment section how that resonated, if that resonated. Now, let's move on to our very last pile number 3. You know, who's been fantasizing about you? What's the details of those fantasies? You know, when do they think about you most? And what action, if any, are they going to take towards you? Let's see what we have going on. We have the 9 of Wands in the upright. All right, so a bit of a struggle. We have the Knight of Pentacles. Someone really admires you. Yeah, this is someone that really admires. I'm picking up crush vibes. This is someone that really likes you. I'm not picking up I'm not picking up that they're in a relationship, but someone that really likes you, admires you from afar. The Page of Cups. Yeah, this is someone who, it's like they think about you off and on. Like, you don't necessarily take over their thoughts, but, you know, almost like I'm picking up that they're focused on something else in their life right now. But if they had a choice of, you know, person to be with, if they were focused on love, you know, they think about you. You're that first person that pops into their mind. We have the 4 of Pentacles in the reverse. Yeah, so this is someone, yeah, it's like they're focused on other aspects of their life at the moment, but you pop into their mind. That's what I'm getting. Or maybe too, this person, you know, is someone that you have worked with or you do work with. We have the 9 of Cups in the upright. Yeah, so this person wants you, just clear. This person wants you, and this person is unattached. And I am picking up that this person is new. Maybe someone you have not met yet, or someone you've met in passing, but I'm not picking up anyone in your current, you know, energy, current, you know, life. Let's see. The Moon. So yeah, this is someone who thinks about you a lot at night. This person thinks about you a lot at night. And so I'm not picking up like like, you know, like heavy sexual fantasies, just like you, literally the nature of the fantasies that this person have of you. I'm, oh my gosh. So this is funny. I'm seeing like a field of grass. Maybe they dream about you. Ah, maybe this is why you come up a lot for them at night. They dream about you too. I'm seeing a field of grass and like, you know, you just lying there. This person just thinks about being around you. They really like your energy, or the personification of your energy, you know, for someone, you know, that's either coming in or someone that they don't know you very much. That's what I'm getting. They don't know you very well. And that energy that they're thinking, you know, like, yeah, it has a lot to do with the energy, you all. It's like they see you as pure. They see you as peaceful. They see you as someone that they can just lie in the grass with. The Page of Pentacles. Yeah, this is someone, once again, they think about you a lot. This is someone who may even be watching you. This is what I'm getting from this page. Even though I usually get watching vibes from, like, you know, the Page of Swords, but this Page of Pentacles, this person is watching you, you know, and it's like, I'm almost seeing someone that's like sitting across from a table looking dead at you. And it's like, you know, for some of you, maybe you're in school, you know, and this is like someone that's in class with you and they're watching you constantly, but this is someone who watches you. This is someone who's they admire your beauty. Like they think you're very beautiful. Like, you know, like, of course, and in the other piles, the person admires them, they're attracted to them, think they're beautiful too. But this person thinks you're like, wow, like the way you admire, you know, your favorite, you know, movie star. Like they think you are very beautiful. Like, it's like they don't generally have an interest in love. That's what I'm picking up, but they have an interest in you. We have the Two of Wands. So in terms of action, this is someone I am picking up. Okay, so I am picking up fall. This is someone who will take action towards you in the fall. And if you're watching this after the fall, you know, maybe this is the fall time or that very next season, spring, you know, or the season that you're currently in. This is someone who's going to try to be friends with you first. They're going to try to establish a friendship with you. And we have the Five of Wands in reverse. Yeah, this is someone who's going to try to establish a friendship with you. In terms of, you know, I'm picking up a young man, young male energy, or young masculine energy. I'm picking up the age 22. So this person, I'm picking up is younger than you, or you're 22, you're younger than them. I'm picking up brown hair. I'm picking up broad shoulders. This is what I'm seeing in my mind in terms of who this person is. So for any of you, if this is describing anyone, you know, I'm picking up, you know, someone with fair skin, but it doesn't have to necessarily be fair skin, but I am picking up brown hair, you know, broad shoulders, you know, or maybe, you know, if this is a woman, you know, she's very broad shouldered, you know, but I'm picking up someone, you know, who has a muscular physique, you know, maybe, you know, this is someone or just like a solid build. You know, I'm picking up someone who's tall. That's what's coming through. Because, yeah, I am picking up a brand new energy to someone you don't know very well. But, yeah, when they think of you, they're not having, like, serious, like, sexual hardcore. In fact, I'm not even seeing sex. They really admire you. They think you are beautiful. And they just think about you. And I'm seeing them, like, lying down in a field of grass and, like, just, or maybe they're lying on the quad of their university. But this person dreams about you most definitely with this moon card in the upright. They think about you a lot at night. They dream about you. They daydream about you as well. They daydream about you. Their fantasies about you are just, they're more so sweet and pure and innocent. This is someone who just really wants to get to know you. And what I'm picking up is they will take action towards you either in the current season or the very next season, as in, you know, summer, spring, winter, fall. Because this reading is being done in fall, you know, at the very tip of fall, we just got out of summer. I'm picking up this person will come to you in fall. You know, this is someone who's going to establish a friendship with you. That's the action they're going to take with you. And it's going to be a sweet romance. It's going to be sweet. And you're going to go forth with this person too. It's going to be very sweet. For some of you, I'm picking up older woman, younger guy. And it's going to be very sweet. It's going to be very innocent, though, you know, this person is attracted to you and you will become attracted to them, but it's going to be very sweet. It's not going to, like, you know, cross over any crazy boundaries, you know, like it's going to be done, you know, very traditionally, very, you know, it's going to be very sweet. That's just he's coming out. All right, everyone. Thank you for those of you who chose pile number 3. I'm sorry. Yeah, that it just it's just something that's very pure and innocent and cute. And just the way that you don't see things done in this day and age anymore. But I am picking up younger vibes. Thank you everyone who chose pile number three. Let me know in the comment section how that resonated, if that resonated, and if you'd like to know more how this pertains strictly to you. Book a reading with me. All the details are in the description area. Click the link underneath book a reading. It'll take you to my Etsy where you can book the reading. All right, everyone, thank you for your energy wherever you are in the world. I hope you're happy. I hope you're at peace, and yeah, see you next video. Peace and blessings. Goodbye.